What I thought I would do today was talk for a little while about some of the geology of Maine's coast, as it's one of the founding ways in which we start to learn about the coastline itself.
I invite you to look at your feet. It's flat. It's been polished, right? So remember that these glaciers are acting like a giant piece of sandpaper, so they're actually smoothing over that, and they're making this really nice, flat, smooth surface. Now, which way do we think the glacier was flowing?
That way.
Okay, so we think it was flowing to the north?
Well, no.
All right, so let's take a look at what the evidence is that we can see again. So that is a glacial striation. What you're seeing here is evidence of a piece of rock that was embedded at the base of a glacier, and as that glacier was scouring across the landscape, it went. So now that we've seen one, I want to see if you guys can see any more.
That one's at like 1 degree.
Five.
Yeah.
Three. Five.
Now is just go over and take some measurements of the orientation of the bedrock to see whether or not the bedrock matches up best with the island topography. It was published in 1971 by Arthur Hussey, professor of Bowdoin College. So what you can see as you look at this map here is that the orientation, the colors themselves, start off kind of pointing this way, and as we go across Casco Bay, they're ending up pointing more north-south. So what's actually happening is that the rock units here were squeezed.